Hi, I'm Rachel, and welcome to the 7th episode of AgVentures, brought to you by Herdwatch. We're here today at Drisgolgoch Farm in Pembrokeshire, South Wales, visiting Sean Thomas and his family, and obviously all of his Pedigree Dairy Shorthorns around us. So Sean, thanks so much for having us on farm here today. Would you be able to give us a bit of an overview as to what you're doing today and also what the business is that you're running here? Obviously, you've got milking out of the way already. We've got some cows in the background. Yeah. But what have you got planned for the day?
Yeah, so milking starts about 5 in the morning and we get done about 7, half 7, and then the cows go up to the field and graze for the day. So we normally have breakfast, then we get on with jobs. So today there's liming happening, there's fencing going on, and there's a bit of tractor driving ourselves going on, and just organising things. And we're preparing for the Royal Welsh Show at the minute.
Yeah.
So getting cows ready to go and leading and washing. And
Busy cows.
Yeah, it is.
So Sean, tell me a bit about the farm. I know you're farming in partnership here, but who are you farming with?
Yeah, so I farm in partnership with my family, with my parents.
Yeah.
And my father was third generation, so I'll be fourth generation.
Yeah.
Which goes back, we've bred Shorthorns for at least three of those four generations.
So it's a favourite breed, really?
Yeah. It's a bit of a family tradition, this breed. So we're trying to kind of make the system work. We milk 750 cows here in North Pembrokeshire at about 700 feet above sea level.
Yeah.
We're running a spring and autumn block calving and then an extensive grazing system where we graze from February till November, possibly December in a good year. The cows produce around 6,000 litres per cow.
Yeah.
And 4.25 fats and 3.4 protein is where we sit on an average. We've got here a 70-point rotary, which we installed in 2015, and that kind of halved our milking times and more. And to be fair, we're probably running less staff now than what we did previously. With less cows as well. Well, more cows now. So we also put in the Dairy Master collars for monitoring the cows at the same time, and that has been a revelation for fertility and better submission rates, and we're getting our groups tighter for the calving blocks.
Yeah.
And also gives you a good indication about how many repeats you've got and when you can scan them.
Doing all that yourself at home, aren't
you? So I'm inseminating the cows and also doing my own scanning as well.
Yeah.
So all this technology kind of helps me and brings me lists of how many I got to do and when I need to do them, really.
Behind us we've got some autumn born calves, right?
Yeah.
Yep. And so if you just tell us a little bit about when you're calving and then obviously how you're rearing them, because they look pretty bang on at the moment.
Yeah, obviously we're spoiled for grass at the minute, which is nice for this time of year because it can go dry, but not too bad in this part of the world.
Yeah.
So we calve spring and autumn, 10-week block in the spring and 12-week block in the autumn.
Mm-hmm.
The autumn's obviously kept inside from being on milk, and then they're weaned at 10 weeks or double the birth weight. And then we keep them in on straw and cake, basically nearly ad lib cake, to get them going really well. And then when they're turned out to grass, they don't have any more feed. Where we use Herdwatch with these is we weigh quite often, about every 6 weeks. So we get a good indication of how much they're growing.
Yeah.
And we get the daily live weight gain worked out automatically on Herdwatch, which is really simple, and it, you've got a nice report at the end. And you can see if something's not doing too well, you can pull it out, you can put it in a group, which I have him feed just to get him to catch up.
Yeah. So obviously with your top and bottom performers, are you then looking at anything to see which heifers they're coming from or what bull it's from, to see whether there's an indication from breeding whether they're not performing as well? Or are you just happy to cake them and carry on because like you've got a pretty big enterprise here? So
yeah, definitely our main focus with heifer rearing is probably getting the group as tight as we can together, because then our spring group, we only have replacements within 2 weeks of each other, so they are within 2 weeks all along. So yeah, if something slips out, it could be because it's had a problem when it was a calf, and then it might join the group that's younger to catch up then. We've been using Herdwatch for 5 years now. It's really impressive how the app has changed over 5 years and how much detail and extra features they've added into. Started off, I thought it was like adequate for what you want for a dairy farm, and then all of a sudden there's a lot of new features came up, and it's kind of more than what you need to run a dairy business. And the mapping, the grass and crops feature, which we're really into now with the new regulations coming in from the Welsh Government, so we're now recording fertiliser applications, spray applications, cultivations, reseeding, and I'm hoping to move on to Herdwatch for grass measuring as well. Okay, this cow has got a bit of swelling in the udder, so I've decided to give her some anti-inflammatory just to see if it gets better before treating anything else. So after jabbing with Herdwatch, I basically go on my phone, put it in what she's had, and what's really good is the milk withdrawal dates will come up because she's going to be out now for 5 days.
Yeah.
So it'll tell me the day that she can go back in the tank.
Yeah.
So I don't need to worry about writing that down or putting it down, because it'll come out of the medicine cabinet and it'll be there ready for when we need, when we've got an inspection.
Yeah, perfect really, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really quick.
Yeah, and is that something you'd use pretty often then?
Of course, especially jabbing. Because I don't always tube cows on the parlour for mastitis, the milkers write it down in the book, but then I'll go and enter them into Herdwatch. And then I'll get the withdrawal dates again for meat and milk, which is really important for us because we don't want any antibiotic in the milk. So, yeah, really handy.
Yeah. So then as well, when you're running Herdwatch, is that like just for you and your family, or have you got other staff members with the app on their phone using it as well?
Yeah. So we've got our two staff actually have Herdwatch back home as well because they've got stock, but they also use it within our business as well.
Yeah.
So one is a tractor driver and he goes away and does fertilizer every week. And he will then input those fertiliser applications and any kind of reseeding we do, we also add that in.
I hear you are pretty keen on showing, obviously, your pedigree stock, but also going to Royal Welsh.
Yeah, so this one went last year to the show. I've got my current show team in. She's not going this year, unfortunately, but we've probably got better in the pen. Royal Welsh, we're very keen on Royal Welsh. The family, we've shown at the Royal Welsh for over 50 years, and my father was lucky enough to be president of the show in 2019. Our hearts are in the Royal Welsh show quite deeply, it's just nice to get away from the farm.
Yeah.
But also do something you really like.
Yeah. So annual holiday and something you're passionate about combined.
That's it, yeah. I know you're working with cows still, but sometimes it's just nice to do something different with them.
Yeah, hopefully we'll see you at the Royal Welsh then.
Yeah,
and fingers crossed that your cows win.
Yeah, fingers crossed. We'll see.